Look, with my feet shackled and my head on the cloud, with my arm free, I gotta be God. What's up, my people? This is Showbiz the Dope. These are the top 5 fights that must happen in 2019. But before I get into that, we must have our message from, you got it, the Keeping It Real guy. Buster Douglas and Antonio Tarver. Good shit. Good shit. But fuck you. So, these are the top 5 fights that must happen in 2019. Now, I want to say first and foremost that these aren't the top 5 fights that I would like to see in 2019. I just think that these are the 5 fights that must happen. At number 5, I got Lomachenko versus Mikey Garcia. Now, personally, I think moving back down would be a bad look for Mikey Garcia. Sort of like when Roy Jones Jr. moved down to face Antonio Tarver and Roy Jones Tarver won. I think he should stay at 147, at 140 at the least. But since Mikey Garcia will be fighting Errol Spence on pay-per-view, more eyes are going to be on Mikey Garcia, and Lomachenko calling out Mikey Garcia in his last fight, this fight ranked at number 5 of the fights that must happen in 2019. At number 4, we have Deontay Wilder versus Tyson Fury 2. From my understanding, it looks like that they're looking towards the April date. But I hear from Tyson Fury's team that Deontay Wilder may not be Tyson Fury's next fight. But Tyson Fury, he himself, he still wants that fight to be next. The reason why I have this fight at number 4, because that fight was their notoriety fight. That was the fight that really introduced them to many of the casual fans out there. So I think that they must run it back as soon as possible, especially after the first fight being such a classic. I think it's a no-brainer for Deontay Wilder and Tyson Fury to have their rematch in 2019 as soon as possible. At number 3, I have Canelo Alvarez versus Triple G 3. Now, in my opinion, I don't have to see that fight anymore. I pretty much got the gist of it. But the reason why I have this fight in the top 5 and so high is because of 2 reasons. 1, DAZN. DAZN signed Canelo Alvarez to that huge deal, and a Triple G and Canelo Alvarez 3 being on DAZN would be a huge fight for DAZN, and I'm pretty sure that DAZN, along with Oscar De La Hoya, is clamoring for that trilogy to end on DAZN. Another reason is, for many people, they still need to see a knockout. That was the reason why the Canelo Alvarez and Triple G fight was a huge deal in the first place. And this is their last chance to do it. At number 2, I have Keith Thurman versus Errol Spence Jr. This is a fight that's been hyped up for some years now. And now that Keith Thurman is back and he's healthy and he's going to fight Lopez, with Errol Spence fighting Mikey Garcia early this year, this fight with Keith Thurman and Errol Spence can definitely happen. They both are with Al Haymon, and Errol Spence fight will be on pay-per-view. And that is extremely important because Errol Spence, out of all the fighters in the welterweight division, will be considered the pay-per-view star. For everybody in the welterweight division who wants to make the big bucks, like Danny Garcia, Terrence Crawford, Sean Porter, and Keith Thurman, those guys would have to go through Errol Spence. And Errol Spence is going to be considered the pay-per-view star. And I don't see any of those guys not willing to fight him for the money. Errol Spence will be in a position after the Mikey Garcia fight, if he wins, to own the platform that the other welterweights would like to fight on. So I think Keith Thurman and Errol Spence can definitely happen by the end of 2019, and I see that fight as a must. Number 1, I have Anthony Joshua versus Deontay Wilder. Now, with Deontay Wilder and Tyson Fury 2 looking to be slated in April, you have the rest of the year to negotiate a big fight with Anthony Joshua and Deontay Wilder. Now, Anthony Joshua has been campaigning in the States saying, look, I want Deontay Wilder. So it seems as though Anthony Joshua, for whatever reason, right now, he is really, really thirsty to make that fight happen. He wants to fight Deontay Wilder. After Deontay Wilder and Tyson Fury 2, if Deontay Wilder beats Tyson Fury, he would be that big star in the States, with Anthony Joshua being a big star in UK, and that makes for a mega fight. So, I can't see why that fight wouldn't happen in 2019. I think it's an absolute must. You're talking about the biggest fight of 2019. So, those are my top 5 must fights for 2019. Let me know what you think. What do you think on the list should be moved up or moved down? Or, which fight do you think I left off the list? Let me know in the comments. And, showbiz the dope.
Listen to showbiz.
I'm out.
Boxing. What's that? What's that?